All right, we are working on some modifications for the twin V, and one of the first things I'm going to do, which is simple and easy, is we're going to use 2 bottles of seafoam. So they say that you can use 2 ounces per gallon. So I'm going to have 1/2 a tank of gas in the boat, and I'm going to add 2 of these, which is actually, they're 16 ounce cans. So basically 2 cans would take care of 16 gallons of gas. And since it's a 30 gallon tank, 1/2 a tank, bada bing, bada boom. The other thing that's going to give us better carburetors is I'm actually going to clean them. So they haven't been cleaned by the guy who owned this boat. I'm not quite sure how long he owned it, but it sounds like they used it for quite a few years. He's never cleaned them, and we're going to clean them. It seems daunting because it's a big 4-barrel carb, but one way or another, it's getting done, and I'm going to learn, or we're going to have somebody else show us. Well, one way or another, we'll figure it out. We'll have our own separate video on how to clean the carbs on our Yamaha 4-stroke. So I essentially went on an Amazon shopping spree. So I have LED lights, this roll right here. It's a strip, it's got 3M tape. So I'm gonna stick the tape up here and go down about every foot, I would say. I'll probably end up putting a black zip tie, which you're not gonna be able to even tell because it already looks like we have black zip ties on this canvas. This roll is only 16 feet, so I bought 2 rolls of it. And this stuff, they say you can actually cut it. All right, so you see right here by this finger, they say if you cut that line right there, they will still work. So that's pretty incredible. Anyway, so you can cut it to length. So we're gonna do 1 full length of this, 16 feet, and then I think we needed 24 feet total. All right, so 24 feet will completely wrap around the underside of this T-top. So when we flip on the light, basically every square inch of deck is gonna be lit up with this thing because our T-top is pretty massive. All right, I also bought a couple of these cup holders, and typically I've seen these in boats like on the side of the boat, and then they snap down and fold up, which is cool. But I'm not gonna try and mount anything on the sides of the boat to get knocked off or anything. And plus, I'll be driving from the center console all the time. I'll line up a couple of these on the dash here. That way it'll keep our drinks right there whenever we smash that gas. All right, so when you squeeze the gas primer bulb, these things are really getting kind of brittle and hard. When these hoses get more than just a few years old, you're gonna wanna replace them. What'll happen is the inside rubber on these hoses will start to deteriorate, and then that rubber gets caught up in your carburetor or hopefully into your fuel filter, but then it'll clog up your fuel filter. So one way or another, not good to have bad hoses. You always want the gas flowing properly, so I purchased a couple of hoses online. These were super cheap. I want to say $13 each. Since we got 2 motors, we need 2 of them. But they look pretty nice. These are not for fuel injected motors. You're gonna have to pay more if you want fuel injected because the hoses can withstand more pressure. Fuel injected gas hose would be under more pressure. So don't buy the cheap ones if you have fuel injected motor. All right, so I showed you the other day, we have an old school fish finder, this Garmin up here. And now we have a brand new Lowrance fish finder on the front. So the whole idea would be able to sit here on this chair, use the remote control that comes with this trolling motor here, and watch the fish swim by on your little fish finder here as you cast out your line. So I think this is going to be a pretty good setup. And mounting it right there, I don't foresee any problems. We can still use our cleat. We can still launch our trolling motor. It's not going to be in the way of unplugging anything. All right, so you can see if we do mount it here, the inside of that storage compartment is right here. So you can see this little lip. That's where the inside of the storage compartment falls. And I might even try and line it up over the center of this. I don't want to call this a pontoon, but maybe somebody who owns a catamaran can explain to me, what do you call the pontoon on a catamaran? So yeah, chime in if you know. All right, so some of you may have noticed this switch right here. So what we did is put in a headlight. So the front of our boat now has a headlight, and the ingenious part about this is it's on the swivel seat. So now our headlight can turn and we can shine it on whatever we want to shine it on.
I just put one small hole here through the floor. We will have to make sure that we don't turn the seat over and over or we'll rip the wire right out. But anyway, one small hole through here and one 3/4 inch hole here. And all the wire harness is inside this compartment here. One of the reasons I didn't put the switch in my dashboard, like most people would say, is because there's no through hole in a catamaran. At some point, somehow, they got wires from here to here. So if you notice, these controls go through these black tubes, and this tube goes through the side hull of the catamaran and up into the center console. But there's no tubes like that that go from the center here up into here. In fact, the hole for the trolling motor, the plug for the trolling motor here, it only runs to right here, and they used to keep their battery right here. So I'm gonna have to figure something out when we decide to run our batteries all the way to the back.
All right, the tongue of our boat is looking rusty and crusty, and these safety chains don't look big enough for a boat this size. So I am definitely gonna be getting these chains off of here. It's super simple. It's just a little bolt that goes right here. I'll throw on some new chains and a new tongue, just for looks. This one works, but why not have it look a little nicer on our nice boat, you know? The rest of the trailer is in really good shape. The ladder is nice, solidly welded on here. The spare tire looks like it's holding the air just fine. Don't have any complaints. All the bolts are still nice. They're not even like rusted or anything, so it's pretty sweet. It only looks like it's been painted over in a couple of little places, but not bad at all. I mean, basically, you do this when it's starting to rust. You spray over it, you know? Look exactly under here. It's starting to rust. So, no problem, though. They actually bought new leaf springs and a new axle. And I guess the axle actually comes with new bearings for this. So I'm happy we have that going for us on this trailer as well. I did notice it looks like the grease either used to come splashing out of here or recently came splashing out of here. If you know what makes bearing grease come out of here, would you mind explaining that to me? Because I don't understand. I've had this happen on other trailers. Some trailers are good. This one's good. Not so good. All right, last time I left y'all, I was debating on whether or not I should put a pole holder here or drill a hole in here, and I did neither of those. The pole holder here would be 2 screws up top and 2 screws down bottom for just one pole holder. All right, so what I did is 4 times as good. I've got 4 pole holders and just 3 screws. So I got these 3 big stainless steel screws in here, and this is a great placement for our poles because there's still enough room to walk in between here if you're trying to get by, and there's poles in the front, and it doesn't stick up any higher than our T-top already sticks. So I'm happy with our placement of our 4 pole holders here. All right, so you've already seen the pole holder in the front. I bought an identical one for the back here. I believe these things are like $35, and I will put a link in the description and you can try these out yourself because I'm very fond. Since the last video, the owner of the boat actually contacted me and started talking in the comments. He reminded me that this is called Marine Tech and it actually works really well. This stuff is super, super hard. It feels like it's gel coat or something. However, I don't like how he just left it unfinished like this. I am going to be sanding this sticker off of here. We will probably use that eraser wheel that we used once before. And then I'm going to sand this down nice and neat. I'm going to take off the Twin V Power Cat. Sadly, that is just not the color scheme we're going for. So the line that I said that I'm going to paint is this bottom one here. So I'm going to just put tape right here and we'll paint all the way up. And then this little bitty section right here will remain white. Why will it remain white? One major reason is because I can't get to it because it's on the bunks of the trailer here. And since the bunks of the trailer are here, and you can see that looks like PVC board or something they put on there, I'm guessing that's going to try and start scraping off any paint that we put on here. When I say paint, I mean gel coat. I'm not going to paint the outside of the boat. All right, you can see the pinstripes. They just get all scratched up. Check out right here. It's getting all worn out. So anyway, we're going to completely change the color and look of this boat, and I can't wait to do it. I'm going to do it better than I did the last bay boat. I'm going to spray it on this time. We're going to make it shine. It's going to look great. I can't wait to do this. All right, so this was the original plan for the deck platform in the back slash seating. It's nice and sturdy. It is wide enough to hold your feet, which is fine. So all that is good. However, there's a problem. So alongside this box, I want to have another dry box. And the dry box will be getting access frequently. Something like this, or the tools you're going to access very quickly. You know, when there's rough seas or things are going wrong, you don't want to have to unstrap this board and this board from the floor, lift it up, try and place it in the boat without knocking somebody in the head with the waves going. It would be crazy. So the new plan is going to be cut these around here. So we're going to make basically a 2-foot by 3-foot platform that's only going to be in the center, that's only going to be covering up the batteries. So if we do need to get the batteries, not a problem. We'll just grab two hands on the platform, pick it up and move it out the way. But like I said, we're not swinging around 8-foot long 2x8s. That's just ridiculous on a boat. So we're not going to do that. We're going to only be able to fish one or possibly two little people on this platform. But that's okay, because two people in the back fishing, we still got plenty of other boats. So it's fine with me. Took some measurements, wrote some stuff down. We cut some stuff. Here are all of our pieces. All right, there it is. Ezzy, tell him what it is. All right, so I made it 3 boards wide, so it's about 16 by 32, I believe. Came out really solid, heavy duty, made from 2x4s and 2x6s. They are not pressure treated, and I realize that wood doesn't go good on boats, but I think what I'm going to try and do is gel coat these. So all this piece and that piece, we'll gel coat that white, and everything will match the boat, and it's going to look amazing. And I'm super excited because now we have room for our safety stuff, our storage stuff, and room for our tools. I'll probably get an enclosed toolbox as well. And this actually hides all the wires and just looks a lot better. Kind of imagine that painted white, and that's gonna look pretty awesome, I believe. So happy about that. See how you do. You ready? All right, dude. All right, so this box already had a hole in it, and I made great use of it. The wires are gonna run out the side, and it has room for our switch, and check out our neons. All right, obviously there's a big gap here, but I bought 2 rolls of this stuff, and conveniently, it has red and black wires on the front end and on the back end. So when the other one comes in the mail, I'm just gonna fold this kind of up like that, and then run our next piece. This 3M tape ran so good and so tight on this that I don't even need zip ties. I put one here, one on the corner, one back there, but that 3M tape is kicking butt, so that was pretty awesome. Do make sure you wipe this down with some acetone before you stick something like that, and that'll really help. Anyway, I'm pretty happy with how that came out. Hey, big man. So it's looking super sick so far. Say hello.
Hello.
Say like and subscribe.
Do like for fishies.
Like for fishies? Yes, exactly. Like for fishies.